I'm going to give a brief introduction here to the idea of catalysis. And a catalyst is something that increases the rate of a chemical reaction so that it reaches equilibrium faster, but it does not itself get consumed. And the idea is if we have some reaction, reactants going to products, and we're going to use a catalyst, then we can imagine the reactant somehow combines with the catalyst to make some intermediate, which is the catalyst and R. And then we end up making the product, and we regenerate this catalyst, which is then available to go through the sequence again. So the catalyst is running around the sequence, and we're converting R to P. So we actually, the catalyst creates a different pathway, often with lower activation energy, and going from reactant to product. Now, the large majority of catalysts are used on industrial scale or heterogeneous catalyst, which usually means solids with high surface area. These are porous materials, can be metals, oxides, sulfides, zeolites, which is an oxide structure that has porosity as part of its crystalline structure, acidic oxides, and so forth. And we have three important properties of catalyst that affect their utilization. We certainly want to have high activity, which means high rate of chemical reaction. The reason being, higher the activity, the smaller the reactor. Of course, less catalyst is used, and this translates to then lower cost. Second critical aspect is high selectivity. And actually, the selectivity often dominates the properties of the catalyst, that we trade off activity for selectivity. So if we have high selectivity, it means we use less reactant because a larger fraction of it is being converted to our desired product. Typically, we have multiple reactions. We have a desired reaction and multiple undesired reactions. Higher selectivity means more of our reactant is going to our desired product. So we have less reactant. We use less energy for the process. We create less waste because often these byproducts, other reactions, are waste. And all these things, again, mean lower cost. The third aspect of catalyst is stability, which means we like it to last a long time before we have to replace it. Well, we mentioned catalysts don't change. All catalysts deactivate. This is important. All catalysts are going to deactivate. The question is, what is the time scale for deactivation? A catalyst deactivate by poisons adsorbing on their surface, by sintering where they lose surface area, by fouling and deposition covers over the catalyst surface. All these things, if we have longer lifetime again, it means lower cost for a large-scale process. So I've listed the steps in a catalytic reaction. We're looking at, this is for reactants. So if this is a catalyst pellet, represented by the circle, out here in the bulk, we have a reactant that has to diffuse to the surface. And then it has to diffuse through the pores to the sites where reaction takes place. So in expanded view, we have some pore, and we might have catalyst distributed along this pore. So it has to diffuse into the catalyst. The reactant then has to chemadsorb on the surface of the catalyst. Surface reaction then takes place where we convert our reactant to our products. And then our products have to desorb from the surface. And then the products have to undergo the reverse steps. Namely, they have to diffuse back out to the external surface, and then they have to diffuse to the bulk. And any of these steps can limit the rate of reaction. If desorption is slow, then that affects the rate of reaction. If diffusion of reactants through the pores is slow, the catalyst pellet is big, for example, or the reaction rate is very high, diffusion can then limit reaction. We can also have surface diffusion being important in the catalytic reaction. So catalysts used on a large scale, the process, most chemicals that are produced involve catalysts. Gasoline production sees a number of catalysts, and catalysts are used to clean up waste streams. such as in the auto exhaust catalyst. If we can create catalysts with higher selectivity, then we create less waste. If we can create catalysts that operate at lower temperatures because they're more active, then we could create less toxic products that might form at the higher temperatures as byproduct reactions. And clearly, catalysts are used on a large scale. Most of them are heterogeneous catalysts.